ladies and gentlemen. My name is Nirbhay Saxena. First of all, I would like to thanks and welcome all the subscribers and the viewers of this channel. My channel can support the people who are still working in the manufacturing industries and the people who have just started their journey in the manufacturing industry. And there are so many people who has to start their journey in the manufacturing industry, like fresh engineers and management students and some other students. I also have 28 years association with the manufacturing industries, especially in automotive industries. So during this 28 years, I faced a lot of challenges related to management expectations. So it is very difficult to meet the management expectations. And sometimes some other challenges are like manage boss, how to manage the boss. And challenges are related to the colleagues, how to communicate all the information, how to upgrade their competence so that they can meet your expectation also. So we face a lot of challenges. I hope the people who is still working in the manufacturing industry, they also face same kind of problems. We do a lot of efforts, but management is not appreciating our efforts because we are not able to meet the management expectation. This video will provide you the new idea and the systematic method or systematic remedies for these kind of situations or these kind of challenges. All the contents of this video is my own perception. There is no relevance with any other video or any other literatures. So this is my own perception. So I hope these tools will help you to manage these kind of challenges. All the contents of this video is my own perception. There is no relevance with any other video or any other literatures. So this is my own perception. So I hope these tools will help you to manage these kind of challenges. Our manufacturing industries are having so many tools and techniques which we are implementing on the shop floors and in the relevant processes. But because we don't understand the objective and the application of the tools, that's why we are not able to meet the management expectation. So here it is important to understand the objective of an activity. Why we are going to implement or establish this activity on shop floor. So to understand this statement, we can take one example. So here the example is for 5S concept. So I hope most of the viewers are aware about this 5S concept, because this is a very common concept in most of the manufacturing industries. So what are the 5S? So 5S, there are 5 different S. 1S, first S is sorting or segregation. The second S is related to systematic arrangements. And the third S is related to sweeping. The fourth S, which is related to standardization. And fifth S is related to self-discipline or sustain. So I hope everybody is aware about this 5S concept. So first S, let us take this as an example. So 1S is segregation or sorting. So segregation, when we ask segregation of what, then the answer would be wanted and unwanted. But the next question could be, what is wanted and what is unwanted? Now the answer will be different for different peoples, because everybody is having their own terminology. But can we understand this 5S is really appeal to the management system or management? So 5S activity is never given any weightage to the management. So they don't expect or they don't understand the outcome of this 5S activity. So here we will share some new idea or new concept related to 5S activity. So I am going to share the first S. So first S is segregation or sorting, where we talk about the wanted and unwanted. So wanted, we can consider the concept man, machine, material, method, measurement and environment. So when we talk about man, a man is working on a particular operation. So when we saw the actual cycle time for this man, so actual processing time is very less, but that operator is taking so much time for some non-value-added activities like picking the material, cleaning the material, holding the material and placing the material and then exit the material and again the store the same material. So actual process time is very less, but non-value-added activities are taking a lot of times. Really, all these activities are wanted. If we highlighted all these activities as unwanted activities, then definitely you and your team can identify some new solutions how to reduce these non-value-added activities from the processes so that we can utilize man time in effective manner. Or if there are total 12 operations in a particular process and out of this activity our outcome could be the removal of one operator, so if we can remove any one operator, then it will be the direct impact to the product cost. We can reduce the product cost, and this is really good for the management. So if we do such kind of activity during the identification of wanted and unwanted activities, then definitely it will result to the management expectations, and this will be helpful to the management as well as organization. The same concept we can use for the material also to identify the wanted and unwanted. Suppose each and every table is having the inventory of 50 parts. So if there are total 12 tables and every table is having the inventory of 50 parts, means we are having the 600 parts inventory on our table. Is it really wanted? And when we identify this activity as a non-value additive, then definitely you and your team can identify some solution to remove this inventory. So by doing this activity, you can improve or you can reduce the inventory norms, which is actually not required or not wanted in the process, which will be the hurdle to the man operations. So if you reduce the inventories, so that will impact in terms of cost, and management will appreciate your efforts because now no more inventories are lying on the shop floor on each and every tables. So this will give us some benefits to the management and the company. Really, all the operators are using all those informations. All the operators are reading all those information on daily basis. If not, then definitely it is a non-value-added activities, which is acquiring some space and which is really not useful in daily production activities. So I think we can remove some non-valuable informations which is not related to the operator on day-to-day basis. So we can save some space for the organization. And if we can save the space in our organization that would result into the cost. And we can reduce the cycle time, we can reduce the space that will be appreciated by the management also. So in same manner, we can think about the machine, we can think about the measurement for in particular activities. People are taking so much time for the measurements. Is it really wanted? Do we have any other solution for that? If we are having other solutions, so it means whatever the activity we are doing, that could be unwanted activities. So if we identify such kind of activity as unwanted activity, so I can assure you that you and your team can identify some solution, and that solution will give you some good benefits in terms of cost, in terms of quality, in terms of space, in terms of man ergonomics, etc., etc. And this will be very useful to the operators, to the process engineers, to the managers, and to the management. And of course, all this activity will result to the customer satisfaction also. I hope if we use this 5S concept in this manner, so definitely it will result to meet the management expectation, customer expectation, and it will be good for the operators, good for the process engineers, and good for the managers to manage and control these activities. My next video will be related to ISO 9001. I hope most of you people are well versed with this terminology, ISO 9001. Most of the organization is having the certification for this ISO 9001. So I have one question. I hope all of you are having the answer for my question. And my question is, we understand ISO 9001 is mandatory for the organizations. But why this activity is mandatory for the organization? If an organization is not having ISO 9001 certification, then what would be the impact? So my question is, why this ISO 9001 is required for an organization? I hope all of you are having some answers. So you can drop your answers in my comment box. I hope this input will be useful to improve your competence, and if you implement all these activities in such a manner, and then this activity can give some real benefits to your organization, which can be appreciated by your management. I also understand if an individual want to implement any new activity on the shop floor, so there are some challenges or resistance from the top line or sometimes bottom line also, because they are not understanding such kind of issues or such kind of good activities. So I request you, if you want such kind of environment in your organization, then you can share this information with your top line and with the colleagues, so that all the people should be on the same platform and your implementation phase will be easier. So if you found all this information suitable for your organization, you can share all this information with your managers, top lines, and the bottom lines also. So this will be helpful to implement all these new initiatives on the shop floor. So once again, I request you, please comment your answers in comment box. So it is my humble request to all the viewers and the subscribers, please drop your comments regarding my next video, that is related to ISO 9001 quality management system for an organization. So I will appreciate your efforts and your inputs, which will give us the feedbacks to make us the new video innovative and useful for your organization. So thank you, and thank you very much.